That might be burn, actually. Oh no. Hello everyone, and welcome to the third episode of my Yu-Gi-Oh! Duel Links free-to-play adventure series. Today, I will be playing the first stage of the KC Cup with my Mindscan Buster Blader deck. I just made the deck, and I want to test different builds for Buster Blader. We're gonna start with Mindscan. I chose that skill because, first off, it is one of the best skills, in theory, for the deck, and two, I don't really want to be paranoid about opponent's back row. In the early levels of the first stage, people can play whatever back row you can think of, and I don't want it to be not activatable, and I'm gonna be thinking, oh, it's a wall of D, and it's gonna end up being the spell. So let me play Mindscan with Pegasus to start off. Now, the build itself, I have 3 Buster Whelps, 2 Buster Blader, 3 Goddess with the third eye, 1 Sangan to pretty much search my whole monster lineup except for Buster Blader, 1 Wizard Buster Destruction Sword and 1 Karma of the Destruction Swordsman just as techs against heroes. Maybe they end up being bad, we're gonna see about that. 3 Destruction Swordsman Fusion, 2 Emblem of Dragon Destroyer, 1 Treacherous Trap Hole, and 3 DNA Surgery. Now, in the extra deck, I play 2 Dragon Destroyer Swordsmans and 3 Dark Paladin, just because I wanted to show off I have 3. You don't really need to play 3, you're gonna need 1, max 2 copies of it. I would run a Stardust Dragon, but I don't have one, so let's go into the duels. So, first duel against Zane Truesdale. Zane gets used, I guess, for Cyber Darks. Or it might be a random deck. I don't really know what it's gonna be. He has 5 in the extra deck. That hand is fine. Could be worse. Could be worse. I'm playing first, so it's okay. Gonna get 1 Buster Blader. Gonna set 1 DNA Surgery and the Fusion card. And then we're gonna wait for his move. Let's see what he's gonna play. Good thing about going first with Mind Scan is that next turn I'm gonna be able to tell what his back row is if he doesn't do damage, which he's not gonna do this time. Oh, he ends the turn. All right, give me something good, come on. And I get Treacherous. All right, that's gonna help. It's gonna stop him from making any crazy combos, so that's fine. Oh, it's Widespread Ruin, so that's gonna be a pain. I need to draw a monster maybe to bait him into activating the card. We'll see. So it is Cyberdex, all right. Let's see what crazy plays you got, mate. Cyber Dark Edge. I hate Edge so much because he can do direct damage, and if you don't have DNA Surgery on the field with Buster Blader, he can pretty much kill you turn by turn. If you have DNA Surgery, he can't do anything, obviously. I'm not allowing that, of course not, because I'm gonna be losing my Mind Scan and I don't want that to happen. So let's fuse and let's get that edge out of the field as well. I don't like seeing that. Give him my Destroyer. I would like a Whelp now. A Whelp would help, or maybe another monster so I can bait the Widespread Ruin. Let's see. Okay, we'll fuse. He ends his turn. Draw. Okay. Not the best. Let's end the turn. Is he gonna play something? Maybe he wants me to attack him, so he might play something here. Is he gonna do it? Okay, Pulse Mind. That doesn't help you. And he does. Okay. Alright, we get a monster. Let's play Whelp. Let's activate the effect. Mill the deck a little bit. So, I think since I already have fusions, I'm gonna get the sword card. And now, let's attack. I don't think he's gonna use it, but let's try anyways. Let's go for some tip damage here.
Take this. My monster attacks your life points directly. Now.
What?
Reveal my face down card.
Okay. Okay, he does activate it.
End my turn.
That's weird. That's awesome though for me, because Paul's Mines can do anything, not only because he doesn't have monsters on the field, but because every monster on the field is dragon, not machine. So why did he set that? Okay, you do nothing, so I can make plays here, awesome. Another whelp, alright. Let's do some damage with the sword. I guess this is the best choice right now. I'm gonna leave my blader in defense. Let's go for the damage. He's probably playing cyber style, so right now I'm giving him cyber style. But can he use it properly? Let's see. I don't think he can. If he has a way to destroy my fusion, then maybe I'm in trouble. For now, we're in a good spot though. He's thinking. Probably don't have any plays. Okay, you're cyber style, so you might have plays. That goes to defense, obviously. Nothing?
I activate my spell card.
Or okay. Okay, not the best. But if he plays a monster, I have treasures anyway. So he had a way to kill my fusion. All right, that's great.
My monster's effect activates.
Okay, you have cannon. And please don't have edge again. Okay, yeah, he gets another edge. Is he gonna play it though?
Come,
oh, he's going with heal, okay. Whatever he played, I'm gonna destroy it anyway. Yep, I will destroy that. And then he's gonna have an empty field. So I can maybe win depending on what I draw. So let's activate treacherous here. Your kill is gone and your proto cyber is gone. Heart of the cards. Oh, heart of the cards worked for Peg, come on now. Let's do this first win with a deck. First live commentary as well. Alright. Let's go for a search. Just to make sure, because he might have a Kuribo here. I don't think Cyberdax play Kuribo. But you never know. As I said, you cannot really predict what your opponent is playing in the low levels of the first stage. So let's play the Buster Blader from the grave. And even if he stops me with Kuribo now, I can fuse into my Dark Paladin and win for sure. So let's see. Do you have a Kuribo? I don't think you have two. Okay, he doesn't have anything. We won. He has an Arcana icon, but he plays Thea. Alright, I had a hope there that he might be playing Blue Eyes. But he's probably not. I don't think Thea can run Blue Eyes. I mean, she can, but... And I'm leveling up, which is good.
Do you realize
Holy Guard, alright, so you're probably, I mean not probably, most likely you're playing Gladiator Beasts, because you have an extra deck as well. And I'm going second. I would have preferred to go first, because that is a good opening hand for the first turn. And I could have seen his back row. Now if it is GB, I can see his back row. And it's probably GB. I think it is GB. Let's see. So I'm playing well, getting a fusion in hand because we don't have any. Then I can get the Buster Blader as well since I have the emblem. And we're good to go. I'm just gonna set DNA and the fusion. And I'm gonna wait it out because if he has GB and I attack, I'm dead probably. I'm interested to see if he's gonna play Hoplomus or not. That might be Hoplomus. Because setting Hoplomus your opening turn is a really good move. Okay, it's not Hoplomus. He has Wall of Disruption, Sakura to Armor, and a Bestiary. Okay. Alright, so you have Murmillo. I'm gonna need to fuse now. So let's toggle to on. And let me show you what I usually do with Buster Blader. So I'm gonna toggle on, yes. And you first activate not your DNA surgery, but your fusion card. You have your toggle to on, then you play the, your DNA surgery, you turn everything to dragon on the field, the chain goes off, and you can pretty much then fusion with his monster. So with fusion with Murmillo, and I get my Dragon Destroyer. Now he can't use his GB effect, which is awesome, but now we need to worry about his back row, and he opened pretty nicely. So let's see. Oh, come on. That's a dead draw now, because I already have all of the DNA surgeries. I think I need to play the waiting game. Now, I'm gonna play Buster Blader, because my whelp is gonna die if I don't do that. So let me play Buster Blader, and we're gonna play the waiting game for a bit. If he sets another card, I might be in trouble. Sooner or later though, I need to wait for a play in order for me to start baiting him into using his back row. Alright, you play Murmillo. Are you gonna fuse? Please fuse. Come on. If he has a Laquari in hand, he can fuse into his big fusion monster, but I don't think he's gonna do that. I mean, if he fuses, it's a horrible move for him, so he's probably not gonna do that at all. I have less cards in deck, which is bad, because he can deck me out. That is the bad thing with Buster Blader. Sometimes, if you don't have enough plays to get over back row, the opponent can deck you out. Depending, obviously, on what deck they play against you. Now, GB, he can totally deck me out. If he contact fuses them, just plays his other monster and waits. Obviously, okay, that is nice now, because is it? I can fuse into another Dragon Destroyer. So I probably need to bait him into using his armor here. Or maybe he uses both of them. So he gets the minus 1600 attack, and he kills off the strongest of my monsters, because because his GB are weak defensively. So let's try and attack, not Murmillo, I'm gonna attack Bestiari, hoping he's gonna activate his trap. I attack you with a monster. If we wait more, he's gonna get more traps. This is not gonna be good, so let's see. Let's roll the dice here. Okay, he activates armor. You can destroy this Dragon Destroyer. By the way, this is the reason why you need two Dragon Destroyer. If one gets destroyed and you only play one, you're screwed. You can't do anything. Pretty much the deck is dead. You only rely on your Dark Paladins and Buster Bladers. Okay, is he gonna use Will of D if I attack now? I guess I'm gonna fuse though. I'm gonna fuse because I need to get the damage. Let's see. Will you use your Well of D? I mean, I wouldn't. It wouldn't be a good play. But I want you to use it. Come on. No, yes, no. He's thinking about it. He's not doing it. Okay. Alright. Did I just miss lethal? Oh, I might have just... Whatever. I think we're in a good spot to win. Because even if he activates... What is this? Okay, Icon. I can buy you a turn. But we don't care about Icon. He's just gonna stall with it. Well of D, we don't care right now. if it's only World of Deep, just because Dragon Destroyer gets 1,000 attack for every dragon on the field. So even if he World of Deep me, he's still gonna take a big chunk of damage. Okay, for some reason I thought I could get Whelp on my hand. I can't. So we're just gonna wait now. Probably though, I don't think he's gonna play a monster. Why would he give me the free damage, you know? Why couldn't you just play Blue Eyes, man? That would be so much easier. You do set? What?
I'm done with my turn.
Okay. So he did have a Lacquaire in hand. Or he just drew that. Why did he set? I don't get it. I mean, he can use his Econ. Okay, we're gonna bait the Econ, obviously. Maybe he has a follow-up play. That's why he did that. Yep, okay, that was expected. Mindscan is so awesome that if you get used to it, you can't play without it. So I might be in trouble after I switch skills for the first couple of duels, then you're gonna be fine. You are in a pickle, Thea, come on. Does he have a follow-up play or no? Okay, that doesn't do anything. Here you go. That doesn't do anything. Oh, Prisma. Alright, Tigerius. I don't really like Tigerius. Alright, he doesn't have a follow-up play. Another win. He's from Japan and he plays Yami Yugi. So that is not dragons. Okay, so he's on a streak as well. I mean, you don't need a crazy streak to level up in these levels, but still, he won his last match. Alright, he plays a 21 card deck. Okay. That's an okay hand though. That is actually pretty great. Let's mill. I'm gonna get obviously, yeah, I'm gonna get another fusion, I guess. Now I'm gonna get sword. I'm gonna get sword because I don't have fusion materials anyway. So there's no point. I hope he can't stop me. Let's see. Right, now the good thing is I'm gonna see his back row next turn. Or if he sets a monster, he's monster. You don't do anything. Alright. So either A, he bricked and he knows I'm playing Buster Blader, so he doesn't need to reveal his cards because pretty much I can't attack him with Dragon Destroyer. Or he just is waiting for his Destiny draw, maybe? Okay, let's go for sword. Let's go in. Let's go in, I guess. Is it a good choice? Yeah, whatever. Let's see, what do you have, mate? You're gonna... Okay, you have a Kuribo. You totally have a Kuribo. I'm not attacking though, because I'm gonna give you Destiny Draw and I don't want that. Next turn, I'm gonna make him use his Kuribo. Wait a minute, if he has Kuribo, that might be burn, actually. Oh, no. Come on. Lava Golem. Mr. Golem is on the field. That is perfect. You still don't set. Why, though? Have you bricked that bad? Okay, we still have Mind Scan. Yeah, if I say no, there's no point, so let's lose 1k points. I guess I'm just gonna attack him. Do we really care about Mind Scan? He doesn't have to He doesn't seem to play back row, so I'm just gonna attack here. I'm not gonna play Goddess because he might have another Lava Golem. Okay, here you go. Force him to play his Kuribo. Yep, my attacks will reach you, mate. Sooner or later. Oh no. Target the right card. Target the fusion card. Oh, come on. That's why most of the time I like setting my fusion card first, because most of the people go for the middle card. So you just chain it, you activate it, and you're fine. Now I can't do anything, obviously. I lost my DNA surgery. That's not a huge problem, because he's probably not gonna play any monsters for now. Okay, you still don't set. Okay, we get... Alright. We're taking that damage too, we can't do anything about it. So Mind Scan is gone. Maybe he was waiting for my Mind Scan to go away. But why do that? You're playing Burn anyway. That doesn't make sense. I would know you have some specific cards. Let's go, let's mill the deck. I would love a Buster Blader right about now. But I'm just gonna get the fusion. I mean, the other card is not gonna help us anyway, so might as well get the fusion. Okay, let's play the Buster Blader from the grave. Now we can fuse into Paladin. Okay, if he has 3 Kuribo... I mean, actually, if he has 3, he's fine. But if he has 2, I win. Okay, he has 1. Do you have another one? Okay. Doesn't seem to have another one. So let's make Dark Paladin. If he has another one and he gets another Lava Golem, I'm pretty screwed. Okay, let's see. Fuse. Paladin. Okay. A fat 3900. And you don't have anything. So another win for me. And we're climbing pretty fast now. So we go against a Yubel, and he's leveling up. If he plays a Yubel deck, we might be in trouble. Because Buster Blader doesn't have that awesome of a matchup against Yubel. But let's see, that hand... it would be fine if I was going first, but I'm going second. So let's see, what are you gonna play? Please break if you're Yubel. What? That's not Yubel. Okay. Blue eyes? Yes, blue eyes. Awesome. I win. If I get... Oh wow. Okay, I get a whelp as well. Yeah, that is awesome. I get a Buster Blader. Okay, I win. Do I win? I think I win. He might have a Kuribo in hand. So... Yeah, I'm going all out though. I'm gonna go all out. First off, let's get a search with Whelp. And let's get... Let's get a fusion card. Now I'm gonna set one of the 2 fusion cards I have, just for a backup, and I'm gonna use the other one. Yeah, I'm gonna use his blue eyes, fusion with my Buster Blader, and then use Whelp and play my Buster Blader to attack his life points directly. I think he might have a Kuribo though, so we're gonna see. He might not, I don't even know what he's playing. I have never seen Yubel running blue eyes. That is the first time. Okay. Let's see, can you stop it? Okay. Yeah, let's battle. Can you stop that? No, 0 delay, so he doesn't have Kuribo. So I probably win next turn. Even if he doesn't play all dragon monsters, I have DNA surgery on the field. So you're pretty much screwed, I think. Yep, he scoops. Alright, another win of the bug.
Okay, so we go against another Jubel. Is it the same guy?
I can't remember if he was using mats and... Oh, okay, it's not the same guy. Because he plays Power of Dark. Alright, so that's probably not a Jubel deck either. And that is a horrible hand. And I'm going first, Jesus. Going second, I have good hands. I'm going first, I have trash hands. Just set those, because I don't want to lose Mind Scan. Let's see. I need to draw a Whelp next turn. And I guess I'm in a good spot if I do that. Oh no. Oh, come on. Nope. We're not gonna be in a good spot. Nope. We're not gonna be in a good spot. He plays Breaker. Perfect. It's like I talked about you in the last video, mate. Come on. I was like, oh no, one card is not gonna be meta changing, and now he's gonna destroy me. Oh, wow. Really? Perfect. We get destroyed. Yeah, I lose. There's nothing I can do. I mean, depending on what I draw, I need a Whelp. Come on. Oh, come on, Konami. Really? Scoop? I'm scooping. Okay, that's it for me in this episode. Thank you so much for watching me getting tilted in the last match. You can leave suggestions in the comments. How can I make this deck better? I would most likely change it up anyway. You can also tell me what deck do you want to see me play in the future for the first stage of the KC Cup. And also you can send me your decks and I might play them on the channel. You can contact me through my Discord. The link for you to join will be in the description. You can send me your deck there. Thank you so much for watching. Once again, leave a like if you enjoyed the video, subscribe for more, and see you in the next one.